Hello friends, welcome to another exciting episode in our CorelDraw effect series. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I created this text cut effect inside of CorelDraw. If you don't mind, if you've not subscribed to my channel, please kindly do so now so that you don't miss any videos I'm dropping in time for now. Without having to talk too much or waste time, let's get started. So the first thing I did was click on File and click on New like this. And I'm going to set this to pixels like this, and I'm going to change the page size to 1920 by 1080, which is the standard size like this. I'm just going to give it a name here, and it's going to be cut effect, right? And I'm going to change this to RGB. Everything else here stays the same. Resolution of course should always be 300, and I'm just going to click OK like this to get started. Okay, so having done that, the next thing you want to do is go over to this rectangle, double click on it to create a replica shape of it, and right click here to remove the outline like we've done in previous videos. Go over to your text tool, and of course I would like to type something out. So what I will just type is very simple. It's just going to be cut, and go up here and select the font choice that you want to use, or the font of your choice. So I'm going to use this. For some reasons I'm not liking this, so I might want to change this to something you guys are all familiar with, which is the Montserrat font, right? So I'm just going to type this in, and yeah, that's Montserrat. So I'm going to click here to see the different variations of the font like this, and what I want to check is the black, right? So I'm going to be using the black Montserrat black, so that's what I'm using. So I'm just going to increase the size manually by dragging from the edges. Note, I'm dragging from the edges, not the side, right? So what I want to do next is still make it bigger. I'm holding shift now to increase it all sides. I can just come up here and increase the size, but guess what, I choose to do this manually. So when you do that, just press P so you centralize it at the middle of the page, right? So go over to your shape tool and create space like this. So what you want to do after this is very simple. Make a duplicate copy of this, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, and set this aside like this, right? So you have a duplicate copy. So with this one inside of the page, the design page, what you want to do is very simple. Right click and click on order, and when you click on order, select to front of page. Now this is to front of page. Now this brings it up to the top of the page, right? Great. So what we want to do after this is I'm just going to change the color. I'm just going to give it this green, right? So make it this green, right? And the background stays at white, right? So make it this green. You double click here and change the variation of green. Click on move this aside. Click on color viewers, and change the kind of view you want to use, right? So click on this, and click on this to select a knife tool. Make sure you're using this first option here, not this one and these other ones. Hold down shift while you drag a straight line across the cut text like this, right? So what you want to do is click out and click out entirely, select this one, right? Click on it again to activate the skew and rotate function. Come down here, and what you want to do is drag this to the right hand side like this, and when you've done that, click on this next one too. Click on it again to bring out those options, and click like this, and what you want to do is also drag to the right hand side like this. So you skewed both parts like this. So select this one. What you want to do is just press P on your keyboard to centralize it. You see why it's very good to centralize things inside of CorelDraw, right? So as it is now, it's stable, but click on it and just make some adjustments. Click this one, click again, and just move it inside a bit so we don't have too much effect. So click this, and what you want to do is hold down Control while you click on this. Click on this one, hold down Control while you click on this to add some extra green to it. So you can actually mix colors by selecting Control and clicking on the color you want to mix it with inside of CorelDraw. So what you want to do is select your eyedropper to select this color and use that color to fill the background like this, right? So slight adjustment we're going to be doing to this. So select this one. So what you want to do with this is very, very simple, right? So make sure you're clicking on the background and click on G to select the gradient. When you click on gradient, you want to drag the gradient from this part to this part. No, make sure you are going from white to green, right? So make sure it's from white to green like this. Okay, so what you want to do after this is you can extend this by just clicking this and dragging this below here. So what you want to do is select this one, click on G on your keyboard to activate the gradient. Of course, we'll want to replicate what the gradient is already. So select G on your keyboard. What you want to do is from white to green like this. So what you should do is position this well so it's straight. You can see that it's also taking the reflection of the light and all of that, so it's quite balanced. Right, great. So I'm just gonna put this back down like this. Great. And I might choose to extend this just a little bit like this, maybe bring this down a bit just like this. Right, so what you want to do is go over to the ellipse tool like this and draw an ellipse like this. Right, so I'm going to be using the black color. Remove the outline, right click on this to remove the outline. What you want to do is go over to the green, this selected, go over to the green section, hold down control and click on green to mix the color with green like this. So what you want to do next is go over to press G and to select your, go to transparency and click on this like this, this way, right? Elliptical transparency. So no, select elliptical transparency, fountain fill, elliptical fountain fill. Yeah, so what you want to do with this is go over to effect and click on convert to bitmap first. Go to blur and select Gaussian blur like this. And you want to increase this up like this, this way. And yeah, so when you're done with those controls, you have your perfect blur that you want. You can close this up. So I'm just going to go up and type what I want to type, which is the context effect in CorelDraw. Right, so I'm just going to do a slight modification to the text. Reduce it first, and I'm going to change the font here and put it at this. Then I can put it well in place where it's supposed to be. Okay, bolden this a bit like this. And hold down control by clicking on black to make it darker a bit, just like this. Okay, great. So you can always change the colors and play with the colors. I'm going to give it an orange feel. I'm going to give an orange feel to all of this. Hold down control, click on this to make it darker. Click on this also. Click on black first, then click on control, hold down, and make this orangey kind of. I'm also going to apply this to the background also. So I'm typically changing everything to orange. So this is something to keep in mind if you want to change these colors ASAP. So with this one, because I converted to bitmap, I would create it from the scratch again. So I'm just going to, what do I do with this? So I'm just going to delete this and create from the scratch. So with your ellipse, create this and give this an orange. Hold down control while you click on this black here to make it darker. Remove the outline, click on transparency, click on elliptical transparency, and go to effect, blur it out, and Gaussian blur, and increase it, voila, just like this. And there you go. So you can make it slightly bigger, and I'm going to change the color of this like this to fit this all together, just like this. Alright guys, if you've enjoyed this video, please don't forget to hit the thumbs up button to like this video so that YouTube is going to recommend it to other viewers also. And please, if you've not subscribed, turn on the subscribe button so you miss any video I'm dropping after this time around. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.